Okay. Alright, Manifold Garden. Let's go. It looks like the stream's running at really low frame rate. Nope, we're back. We'll see what happens when I get in here. But it ran down to like 17 FPS at one point, and I was like, what? Yeah, like this. Is that crispy? Okay. I don't need that. Let's just turn V-Sync on. There you go. Way better. Actually. It's just VSync. There you go. I don't know. It's got 14 settings. Okay, so welcome everyone to Manifold Garden. A very interesting looking game. Where we are in the wildcard dimension. That's right, we're visiting Busco World today. This is going to be a big brain Busco puzzle game, but it's kind of a good length for a couple streams, which is more or less what I have time for. I'm not sure if I'm going to be able to stream next Wednesday. This might be the last Wednesday I can do until after Xmas. But yeah, welcome. This is puzzle game. So as I said earlier, I'm testing out the new Twitch feature of having separate audio on the VODs. I've achieved this by using the Windows built-in. Oh, audio. Changing the defaults. The one problem with the Windows thing that really annoys me is that if you close the program, reopen it, even though Windows remembers what you set it to, OBS doesn't. So you have to like go into Windows and reset it and then set it back again. It's very annoying. So it may not have as much what do we call? Bandwidth, is that the right word? As many legs as I hope it would. It is very silly. Anyway, here we are. This is Busco World. So it's a puzzle game. This is all I know about it, by the way. It's a puzzle game that deals with the idea of recursive infinitude. And that was enough for me to want to play it. And I bought it on Steam. Y'all know, I got like a shitload of credit saved up. And I was like, yeah, why not? 15 quid. And it's been doing really well. You know, it's been praised quite highly in certain circles. So I'd be interested to see what it was like. Hey, Supernose. This is Manifold Garden. Okay, so right now it's very simple. We just... Oh. Wait a minute. Oh, this is new. Okay. Yeah, and then take this block and put it here. Okay. So. Puzzle. Sometimes, you know, sometimes I thought it would be fun to play a puzzle game because sometimes I'm really good at puzzles and sometimes I'm like totally blind with puzzles, but I think I have a pretty good track record. And so, I haven't really played a puzzle game in a long time. Not since Portal. I don't really play games like this, usually. Whoops. Pretty straightforward. Just grab the cube. Oh. Ah! Not quite so straightforward as you thought, was it, Batman? Yeah. It's Bisco time. Oh, that was a good sound, wasn't it? But yeah, I like the look of the game. It's minimalist, which is nice every now and then. Especially since I've been playing Cyberpunk, and that's like every graphics option you could possibly imagine turned on to full and suffering for it. Oh boy. Oh. What's this? Okay, so. Green is no good. But blue. Okay, I think I understand now. The arrows, I think that's the gravity that these blocks are. Are moving in, and so what if I put this here, and then I do that, and I now. No. I can only pick that block up when I'm on that plane. Okay, suddenly, it's puzzle mode. Let's go. So. Oops. I don't think I'm supposed to go back here. I need to figure out how to get the blocks to turn. Scroll wheel, okay. Is there another way? I think it showed me this control, but then I missed it. You're doing Dose of Ash on the Sly. Ooh. Good fun. No, we just check the controls right quick in case there's something I missed. Rotate clockwise, counterclockwise. Photography mode, interact. No, that was it. Okay. So we put this here. Right? And then we put this here. That's how you do it. This is some big brain Kawashima game, right? It's gonna take me like 1,000 hours. Oh, look at this nice tree made of lines. Ooh. So, it grows cube. Tree grow cube, good. Oh boy. So yeah, if you do have vertigo, I'm going to give you fair warning now. Because I can straight up do this. And get to the other side of the level. And now we've added a new dimension to our puzzles. And that is precisely why I wanted to play this game. There's no jump button, by the way. So, I want to get to that tower, right? So the easiest way is going to be... Well, I don't think I can... I think the easiest way is to just do this. There you go. But I also think I need a blue cube. It's all about falling. Hello, the real climber. Welcome. So what I need to go back and get the cube... Gimme. Ah, that respawns that. Okay, good note. Now I understand. Bop, bop, bop. I was trying to land on it. That would have been amazing, wouldn't it? You didn't mind a VR flying game. Never think I've ever... I don't know if I've played one, actually. There we go. Drink it in! We're dropping a couple, aren't we? It's getting crusty again, isn't it? We don't need that. Let's turn that down. There we go. See, I've done the VR stuff where you, like, fall off buildings and shit, and I got really used to it. Got used to a lot of things in VR. Pretty quickly, actually. It always fascinates me, recursion like this in games. Especially when it's, like, really smooth and you can't see the seams. Because, you know, we could just walk up these steps for, like, an eternity and we'd eventually get to the... back to where we were again. Super cool. Manuel! You're back and you're in a different stream. How does that feel? About to blow your goddamn mind. In Manifold Garden. Doing alright, Neil, thanks. That's... how are you doing? I see you were playing XCOM earlier. I don't think that's what I want to do. Can we... go back on the floor? Nope, shit, okay. I've ballsed it up, chat! Hang on a minute. Okay. It's also about architecture. It is indeed. It's very... in fact, that's how I know of this game. Through a video about architecture, more or less. Hi, Shiggy. Both of thee and Rob went down like wet paper towels. I see. See, I need to get back to there because I've forgotten where I was supposed to be. Oh, this seems fine though. Let's just do this. Feel like I've really balls this up. Right, okay, fine. Right, we're back. We're back in... what do we call it? Let's call it... vertical space. Like, we're the right way up for the thing that we need. You lost everyone, it's a game over, that's a shame. Alright. Button. Reminds you of Monument Valley. It has a similar minimalist art style, doesn't it? In some respects. Although that game was more about forced perspective. This is also, I suppose, a game about perspective, right? But it's more locational perspective. Oh, okay. I don't know why I was trying to... that's why, because you can't actually... So I was thinking what I would do is... this. I don't know if I can keep this. Okay. Ooh. Boom. Lovely. Oh. Okay, we're in a new room. A room with three trees. Two trees. What? We got blue and red. Oh, we've got red. There's a blue tree. And there may be blue someplace, but I think red is what we want. So we need... I also suspect that this might be necessary to success. But how? Oh. Let's go here for now. That's right. We need to... We need a blue block to stand on. Oh. It's gonna take some getting used to, isn't it? These sort of lock together. I wonder. I do that. No. They don't. Uh-oh. I didn't mean to do that. But I was thinking, you know, that would be a good idea. But it turns out it wasn't. Oh, wait a minute. Scratching my head. Okay, we'll get it. We'll get it. We got the red cubes that go that way. Two cubes that go that way. So we need to get the red cube as high as we can so we can get it onto the bottom of that platform. I don't think we can climb up them, can we? Oh, but we can walk up them. I see. I see. Gotta... Kinda see. I was like, what if I could do this? Oh. I thought they always locked into place. That's a game changer, also. Now we can do the thing I was trying to do. Oh, just like that. I don't know if this is the intended solution, but it works. So I'm not gonna knock it. Oh, wait. Yeah, there we go. And then we just go, whoop! There you go, baby. It worked! I'll take it. Let's go! Oh. Beep. Nice. We're in the green space. It's very nice little sound effects as you stand and walk around on things. So what we want is a cube. I get it. We solve the puzzle and then we get to the tree and the tree lets us put the cube in here. And there should be at least two more of these. Hi, Furby. Is this from the makers of Antichamber? I actually have no idea. I also don't know what Antichamber is. So yeah, there's one laser. Alright, next puzzle. Oops. I need to do that. Oh, let's go again. They are not the same people, says the real... Is that Kleinbar? The cube is not for yipping. Honestly. Honestly, Neil. Oh, that's right, it probably isn't. Ooh. We've entered Piano World. It is wonderful. And it's... tone. So far. Okay. Big brain mode. Activate. How do... Okay. That won't work. Cube ain't plugged in. Okay. Oh, right. Have to be the right way up to press the switch, I'm guessing. So I have to be able to stand on the thing. Oh. I want to be able to, like, shoop and drop onto that bad boy. This could be much simpler than I'm making it. You just do that. Okay. Yeah, it's pretty good fun. I like it. It's making me use my brain, and I don't always like to do that when I'm playing games, which is why I play Yakuza, but today, it just felt like a good day for it, you know? It's pretty chill. And I think both of these go in later, and it's a shorter slot, and why not? Okay, so. I can't get that. We're gonna need one of those red cubes, I suspect. That looks too high. That is too high. I'm gonna need more than... I might have to use the red cubes first to create some kind of stepping system to get that up there. Poor Lynchy. Othi's doing the translation game where Lynchy travels through places murdering a language. Oh, right, that game. Yeah. What was that called again? Eden's Gate, was it? That also looks pretty cool. I like language game. It's good fun. Haha, I cheesed it, kinda. No, that's more or less the intended solution, I want to say. Heaven's Vault, Eden's Gate? Where did that come from? Heaven's Vault. The game where Ulfthi's version of Lynchy goes about being an arsehole. Right, I remember it. You called it Heaven's Gate earlier. Eden's Gate, Heaven's Gate. Heaven's Vault. Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. Oh, ow. We did it. A little different from Yakuza, isn't it? We're not like punching people in the nose, we're doing Busco Wildcard Dimension Cube Puzzle World. And for my next trick, a lot less karaoke, yeah. Lots of noises, though, and that's good. Whoop! Oh. Some shit's going on down there. For sure. Yeah, I guess we'll deal with that later. It's puzzle time. Enter another monumental ziggurat of puzzle cubedom. Oops, I keep right-clicking because of my stupid hands that do that automatically. Which does that. Okay, one more. Yellow cube. Purple cube. I suspect we might need this. I'm gonna do that. Something tells me we're gonna need it. I think they were just the two cubes. Yeah, this is straightforward enough. Yeah. Yeah, a little closer. There we go. I did it. That was an easier puzzle. But then that's relative too, isn't it? Because they're gonna get easier the more you do them, and you start to learn the intent behind the design of the puzzles and the game. Hit! Whoops, keep doing it. Is this solving your rage headache, Niall? Oh. 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 Shit's getting weird.
Okay.
Should we go into the black hole? That seems like a good idea. Shmoving. It's shmoving. See, the weird thing is, I think someone's doing some, like, washing in the next door apartment, but I think they started it as soon as that happened, and now my floor is vibrating, so it's like super full body haptics. Yes. The walls are shifting. The snakes begin to laugh. No, come back! I need that singularity. That did not work. Okay, I'll try that again. The Negacube. Okay. We've entered music world. That was fun. So now we've entered the wildcard dimension. Level 2? We've gone deeper. We need to go deeper. Is it an eye? Could be. Depends how you interpret it. It looks like fourth dimensional space to me. There's an entire thing there, but we only see fragments of it. At any one time. Sorry, a 4D object viewed in 3D perspective. And there's a tesseract. So what do you know? I think we've basically... that is a 4D shape, isn't it? Okay. Well, this is a representation, I think, of a tesseract anyway. It's difficult to say. But if you imagine... if you imagine a sphere, or a circle that grows larger and smaller, you can see it as being a cross-section of a sphere that's moving through 4D space. So... you're only ever going to see one part of it at any one time, because we can only perceive things in three dimensions. Unless you count time. But because it exists in the fourth dimension of time, we have to use time to see the whole thing. And that's why you see bits of it disappearing. So, I'm gonna take this here tesseract. It's mine now. You can't have it. Oh, it's all anaglyphic and, chromatically aberrated. Oh, like that. That's a nice effect. Spin the cube! That's beautiful. Okay. Well, it's mine now. It's warping. I'm beginning to think that taking this has disabled my ability to see things properly because it's warping the visuals. Some lovely chromatic aberration, yes. Look at that. Whoa. Dare I put the Tesseract in the thing? Oh, rainbows. Oh, okay. Yeah, I see. Ooh. Ooh. Isn't this my old logo, more or less? That's great. Game was made for me. Okay, so I've spawned some very modern Romanesque architecture, I think. Let's go to where did I come from? Where do I go? This way. Where are we going, Busco?
The wildcard dimension?
The music suddenly cut out. Uh-oh. It's not usually a good sign. Oh well. Leap! Oh. Other way. Wait. Where am I? Oh yeah. Yeah. Ahem. Try that again. Leap! Wee! Ow. Stop doing that, fingers. I swear to God, I'm gonna have to put the compression gloves on soon. To stop if I'm gonna do that now. These silly hands. Okay. That will help. It's a temple. I miss the Tesseract. I want my Tesseract back. Maybe I'll get like a three sphere next. That'd be great, wouldn't it? We'd go through the whole gamut of higher dimensional shapes. Okay. I like that kind of weird door noise it makes when you take one of these doohickeys. Okay. Whoops. This could be a brute force, but nevertheless, if it works, it works, right? I'm gonna go ahead and say this is not how I'm supposed to do this. What's a three sphere? That is a sphere in four dimensions. There's another name for it, but I always forget it, and it's easier to just call it an N-sphere. And then as you go up to four-sphere, that's a fifth-dimensional sphere, and so on and so on and so on. Ah! I don't know. I ain't no mathematician. I just know a bunch of stuff about shapes. But clearly not enough about how to get them where they're supposed to be going, huh? We're gonna have to think about this one. Phew. Now, there's some place here I should be able to drop. I'm gonna pour a drink while I think about this one. This game's currently $11.99 on Steam. That's awesome, because I bought it like 2 days ago for $15.99. It's fine. I'm happy to support the developer, but if you like what you see, definitely worth a shot. It feels good to play. So. Right now I only have a very select couple of ways of actually getting cubes in the opposite direction of where they're supposed to be. I need to stand on a platform, so the easiest way to do that is to stand on the lowest platform, usually, but in this case, might not be that straightforward. But if I can get these cubes high enough that I can stand on something and reach down and grab them, then maybe that will help. Wait. Oh, there's a thing, a place I didn't see. Is this where I came in? It is. Maybe I just do have to do it this way. Oh, thanks, Neil. Yeah, that SoundCloud has got a couple things on it. I've started putting more things on YouTube. Because SoundCloud has limited space, it's a little difficult to work with in that respect. Boy, that's not what I wanted. It works. Okay. There's no, like, crouch. Oh, that, yeah. If I move them around here, I can do this. I still feel like I'm brute forcing it. Perhaps it's not. Well, it worked. Can you explore a little more? I can. In this area, you mean? It's just a door here this whole time. Oh, thank you for not telling me that. Sincerely. That's classic. Classic me. Okay, fine. And that was the entrance, so, yeah. I busco'd it, everyone. I busco quandried it. While I'm here, though, I want to check this door. Yeah. No, I appreciate it. I do. Because if I'd not seen that, I would have thought that that puzzle was messed up the whole time, and I'd be like, what was that? Or I would have never been sure what the real solution was. And I would never have been able to shake the feeling that I cheated somehow. Barry. Barry! I mentioned this to Pastry the other day in Resi stream, but I was playing a game while she was playing Resident Evil. And I forgot what game it was now. But a person said Barry in Jill's voice. She went like, Barry! Banging on a door. It was Cyberpunk. And I thought, I looked over because I was like, is this Resident Evil original voice, Jill? But it wasn't even in her game, it was in my game. Oh. Stairs world. Well, I guess we better start walking down these stairs. I'm kidding. We're just gonna do this. Whee! No, we're not. I want to go the other way into expanding forms. How do I do that? This way. All right. Hold on to your ledge. Oh, not what I wanted. Actually, I wanted to go that way. I still want to go that way. Whee! This is fun. What happened? Hello. Barry! Oh, we came to Stairs World. Imagine finding some hidden thing by accident. That would be something, wouldn't it? Ooh. Art. Force field. Ooh. Shall I put this back? I'll put it here. Bonk. Trees there in case I lose it, I guess. This way. Sealed! Yeah. I see. Walkway. Okay, we're gonna need a coop. Give them. Lay drop. And then I want another one because I like them. I see. That's why they're translucent. Well, no, not really translucent, are they? That's why they got holes in them. Because we need to get the cube in the right... Ah! Stop it. Place. Oh, okay, Neil. You lie down, buddy. Take it easy. Ah, and there's a shadow. Of course, the cubes cast a shadow of light, which is a weird thing to say. They cast a light. And then I can go... Whoa, puzzles! We're doing it. So apart from that one where I completely missed that one door. It's going pretty well so far. Oh, this place is nice. This is a big space. I bet this game really sucks for people with megalophobia. I am actually going to double check this. Yeah, I'm pretty sure that's the door I came out of. Megalovania? Megalophobia, the fear of large things. It's often large structures can trigger it in people that are afraid of large objects. I never understood it myself. I find large structures fascinating more than anything. But then again, what's to be understood about fears, right? The amygdala is a weird thing. Let's, Alright, we need two cube. One such cube. Go in there. One in there. Ah, there's a thing we can do. Oh, gears. A new shape. Neat. You have batophobia. It's related to megalophobia. Batophobia. Bato. What is that? Is it like holes? Or is that something else? You look up at a tall building. Oh, that. Yeah, that's related, isn't it? That's very similar in some respects. For the benefit of the VOD viewers, batophobia is when you're looking up at tall things and it looks like it's gonna fall on you. I guess it's a fear of tall things. Okay, this cube is neon nerds, sherbet colored, I think. Is that right? So that's curious. I feel like this might have, well, it definitely has one direction this way, but I think it might also be feasible in both directions as a trigger. Went to Royal Albert Hall. Oh yeah. That place is nuts. I missed a bunch of stuff. Yeah, I don't know. I know about vertigo. I definitely don't enjoy heights. I've gotten better with them. Just, it's a strange feeling that a lot of people get, that you can just lean out over something and then it feels like you're tipping forward, right? I think that's pretty common. And it makes sense, I guess. Our monkey ancestors are probably... Oh, shit. No? That's not how that works? Okay, I thought it... Use your Busco brain. Goodbye, cube. Okay. Well, I mean... I think we did it. Whoop. Mm-hmm. That feeling that you could quite easily just lean forward just a little tiny bit and fall. And you know you'd never do that, but you could. That actually was brought up in an old Vsauce video about terror. Which also was very interesting. Okay. Sometimes bothers me that the music cuts off very sharply when I go through a portal, but I'm sure there's a reason for it. Whoa. Mm-hmm. Have you ever seen the film Vertigo? Is it Hitchcock? I watched it not long ago, actually. It was really good. I watched it because I listened to a podcast, The Art of the Score, that was all about the soundtrack to movies, and they did one on Vertigo. And I thought since I hadn't seen Vertigo, I would pause it and listen and watch the movie and then go and listen to the podcast, and it was a fun time. I feel like I'm wasting... something if I don't do this. I just really wanted to do that, you know? It would have been a waste of potential if I didn't. Strange how fears just make us more susceptible to the thing we're afraid of, isn't it? But that's the idea, I think. One of the ideas behind that phrase, the only thing to fear is fear itself. And what I take from that is really the one thing that to be afraid of is not being in control of yourself. It's the fact that something will be so frightening that it will terrify you and you will not be able to stop yourself from getting hurt. Basically, that's how I see that phrase. I don't like the idea of night terrors. Like, I mean, real night terrors, in that you just wake up screaming and you're not thinking. You're just animalistically, instinctually lashing out against some unknown, invisible threat, and that bothers me. I don't want to ever be not in control of my actions. Unless I'm really, really drunk, I'm okay with that. I'm gonna keep going down the stairs. Okay. The wolf dream. The light here is a clue. The light is our clue to recursion, right? I thought I saw something. But it was nothing. Bonk. Bonk. There's a wolf in my closet. I'll keep going down towards this tessellated thing. It's a cool pattern. I like it. Move in the direction of the weird geometry. Oh, it's a nice song. It does classify as a dream, as I understand it. It's when you're in the sleep paralysis state, and something opens your eyes, and you can't actually move your body. And so that makes you afraid. And yeah, you're probably still having... Brain is weird, right? It sees things that aren't there all the time. In fact... Yeah, the very fact that you're looking at a screen that's showing you red, green, and blue, and you're seeing purple and yellow and pink, you know? The brain is weird. It sees things that aren't there. But I think that kind of explains those kind of night terrors. A lot of people seem to think there's someone kneeling on their chest. And it always makes me think of, like, Sadako. Okay, so I like this place. I'm gonna fall a little bit. Yeah, just one more drop. Punk. That's where we just came from. What am I doing? We need to go that way, right? It is bloody transcending. Hello, the official Gibbs. I like a good bit of ambience. It's quite oscillatory, isn't it? It reminds me of Lossel in some ways. I forgot my cube. I need a yellow cube from the tree. Alright, we're going back. You bolted. You ran from the wolf. It still fascinates me, just the weird shit the brain does. I mean, it's so stupidly complicated. Bunch of mucus and jelly and electricity inside a skeleton covered in meat that has a job somehow, you know. Okay, I see what we gotta do here. Get the cube to the place. Think juice and some giblets. Are we our brains? Nobody knows. Ah, I dropped my cube into the muffins! Perfect. Although, I will say, I found the edge. The illusion is broken. That's where the loading zone is. You see it? Sometimes we say stupid brain, but isn't our brain who we are? I don't know. There we go. Funny thing about consciousness is that it's actually kind of impossible to measure it. You can measure activity in the brain though, right? And that's how we deduce that someone is conscious or not. Kind of like time. You don't measure time, you measure the effect that time has on objects in the third dimension. Anyway, why are we talking about all this crazy big brain Busco shit? We're just moving cubes around in space, right? I'm not here to give a science lecture. I'm just here to move some cubes around. Electric Jelly. A really cool band name, actually, but that's what I think brain is. That's what I think brain is. Oh, it's like Minecraft, like with the tubes. Peck it. I really know a whole lot of, like, random facts, don't I? Oh, baby! It's a ball puzzle, that's great! Okay, I see this. I set my first rodeo. Boom. Boom! Here we go! Okay. Nice, it's a sphere. We've moved up from cube to sphere now. I'm gonna try and learn more things so I have more random facts. And then next time I play this game, I won't have run out of interesting things to say. Oh. There was a new Kurskasakt video about the moon. No, was it the moon? It was about Earth. No, there were two. There was one 2 weeks ago. There was one about the Earth if it went out into space and we had no sun anymore. And then there was one about the moon and what would happen if we nuked it. It's just, you know, it's a good watch. They'll recommend that video. Okay, something is creeping through reality and that's usually not a good sign. Again, a very cool shader. Screen space. It seems localized more than screen space. So, what was I doing? Oh yeah. I need to disable the red. I like the moon where it is. Would the ocean give up? In what scenario would the moon? Well, if we nuked the moon, it probably wouldn't do very much at all, to be honest. Just think, like, I don't remember what they went into in the video, and I'm no rocket scientist, but I feel like the moon gets hit by meteorites a lot, and I'm not really sure a nuke would do a whole bunch more than they could. They probably just wouldn't care. Oh, dude, I can get another tesseract here if I'm a big smart. Okay. How do I become a big smart? Chat, help. How do you do it? How do you become a big smart? Wait a minute. Become genius. Guys, it's a xylophone. But it only has, like, a bunch of microtonal notes. I'm having way too much fun with that. I want to be a monkey! Go back! Hello! Oh, I'm in a new... Oh, God. We're in sphere world. Okay. Bloodborne ladder. Oh! More cursed trees. That's not... I suppose it technically is a cube. Y'all are poisoned. I'm taking this. Oh. Actually, I think I need to put the thing, the tesseract here, right? To fix the fabric of reality. That seems good. I'll do that later. Where are we going? Where are we going? Maybe I had to go up there. That seems like a clue. Ah! Here. What is? Worth a shot. Clean day. I had a clean day. Yes, Monday. Okay. Is this the same curse tree from before? I think so. So what we need is probably to get out of this building, actually. I think what I need to do is find out where that circle thing, the sphere, comes from. Right there is a tree. Oh! Almost. And this tree has a cube. And now I have a cube. Ah. Good start. But what? Oh, I see. There's a thing. It's probably not where this goes, but got it. I can make this quicker, can't I? Let's go this way. Bong. Hi. Okay, so this is where I was trying to get. Oh wow, this is just one space, huh? Oh, a map. Behold. That's the first area we completed. Guess we'll come here later. But right now, I'm gonna have to abandon that cube. Something over there that makes use of it. Okay. There. Wait, no, I already did this puzzle. This is the staircase. That's what white cube means. It means you already did it. Okay. Perfect. Oops. Wrong way. Works for me. Okay, now we're stuck. Now we need the yellow. Okay, so yellow is easy enough to get. It's just there. I really like that mechanic, just the way the trees respawn them for you. It's a nice reset. No. Oops. I think I left my cube up there. It's okay, I got it back. Honk. Goodbye, Sphere! And there's also this different color based on the normal direction, which is really nice. Because it helps you orient yourself a little bit. This is going to take a while. Thee? Would you like a pork, Ben? There's one on the way. Oh, there will be shortly. Hold on. Okay. Here's your pork, Ben. Get ready. There you go. Just for you. Okay, this way. I think I'm beginning to understand the mechanics of this location. Okay. What? How do you do, all for thee? I hope you've had a fine day. This music reminds you of, what was his name? I remember it. Big brain, come on. Masakatsu Takagi. the composer for the Wolf Children. This looks like something also they would get on really well with. Maybe. I don't know. Do you play puzzle game? We slept all day, only just responded to your admin question. Oh, I see. I was streaming, so I guess I have not checked it, but I think people told me you were playing Heavens something, that we always get the name wrong. Words game, language game. Oh god, okay. Oh, you know what this means? We get a new shape. No, not Heavenswood. I love this shader, this is great. Beautiful, okay. This is my favorite part. Yeah. You got back with sausage. Oh, I really wanted a sausage today after that dog picture. But I had broccoli and eggs and chimkin. Don't use a your puzzle solving juice because you're a bilingual MVP. Oh, goodness. Really? I've gotten like one right. I feel you put too much faith in me. Also, I might be half asleep by then. No offense. It's just I get really tired these days. Oh, please give me another Tesseract. It's my favorite. Somehow I'm not a Wordsmith MVP. How could this be? I don't know, Pastry. I don't believe it. Right, we need to find our way inside. Looking for us, we're big Busco smart. We're small Busco smart. We have to go this way. Pastry gets a participation badge. A special t-shirt. Nega xylophone. I've done it again. Oh, it's there. Okay, here we go. I'll have you know I'm the 5-time champion of being dead last in the spelling bee. That's wonderful. It's nice to be recognized for something. Here we go. Unfracture spacetime, please. Sounds like a good time for another drink. Enjoy this fourth dimensional mandala. Point proving she spelt spelling bee wrong. Oh. Okay, one moment. So we've got another half hour of this, and then we can pass you over to both of you. This is kind of like a perfect 2-hour game, right? I think if I spent more than 2 hours in it at any one point, I might lose my sense of reality. Here we go. Do they have this in VR? I've thought that as soon as I saw it, and I don't think so. Okay, we had a blue Tesseract, and now we have a red Tesseract. Those might and probably do. correspond to the axes of X and Y. Sorry, X and Z. Y is the green axis, so... I look forward to getting that next. Anyway. Oh, shiny! We got a new bauble for our geometric Christmas tree. So that's really what this is about, right? Ooh. Get out of here! Birds! That's a nice effect. Ah, red water. Okay, I see. I did it. Next. We might be able to make it through the next area, then. If we do, that would be great. As I reckon that might put us around about the halfway point. Maybe a third. I've seen people spend between 5 and 10 hours on average on this, which I guess depends on how good you are at figuring out the puzzles. This is where I came from, so I'm gonna put myself on the higher end of that because I don't know where doors are. This is the blue one again. So they were both connected after all. I think I'm beginning to see more of what's going on here. Kind of pulling everything into this singular power. Aligning everything. Button. Yeah, I can do that puzzle. That one's easy. Oh, cathedral-like structure. This is nice. Oh, imagine a Souls game in this environment. You, like, yeet an enemy off and you're like, ah, I beat you, but then he just, like, falls right back down again. Here you go. Oh, never mind. I'm gonna take this with me just in case. You never know when you're gonna need it. Cube. Like there. Oh, we're back here. I forgot that we actually went through like a portal into that area. Marigold Garden. Souls games aren't hard enough. Let's make space not make sense. I would be absolutely 100% down for it. I guess it's... you get this with Portal, right? Portal's a really interesting example of how... You start the game and you don't really understand how the puzzles work because you're not used to the idea of seeing non-Euclidean space, right? I feel like I just came from here. But then as you get through it, you suddenly just get used to the idea that how portals work, and then it's like normal. Space Souls is technically Bloodborne. Kinda, I guess. Cosmic horror and all that. Yeah, you get used to the idea of how portals work, and much like this, I guess if you had a game like that was set for a long time in this kind of environment, you'd just get used to it. Oh, is that a Tory gate? Right, we've cleansed all the evil spirits now, let's go. You learned to think with portals, precisely. Now you're thinking with portals. I mean, just imagine fighting four kings, but having literally anything to go off. Oh, that was good. Okay. That's an interesting idea. So these are rotated. Okay. Oh, I'm going in there. I like the little noise it makes. Sculpture. Isn't there a... Yes, there is. There's a camera mode. Which I totally forgot was in the game. So you can, like... I guess within certain constraints you could do change the colors of the world. Oh, like the edges all thick, you get like direct control over the shaders. Pretty cool. You don't have a body? No, we don't. If we had a body we'd see ourselves from a distance, I guess. Alright, well this is my cube. This is my only cube. I need to go over there to the big machine. It's like a pagoda, I think. Yeah, I see it. Clockwork pagoda. What do I do with this? It would be weird, wouldn't it, Furby? But you could wave it yourself. Well, actually, you probably couldn't because there's rotational physics going on here as well. So... that might be a problem. Where does this go? I would know that I'm waving to the back of myself and I'd be okay with that. That's a little sad, don't you think? But I understand. I'm just falling. See if I can spot something as I... Wait a minute. This leads into this pillar. Green water. Just realized that when you walk on the glass, it plays a tune. Like glass bells. Fall a little longer. We'll find something. There. I see it. Or I thought I saw it. Note to self, remember where you came from. Just scream out when you feel like you need a little help. I appreciate that. You must have played this before, huh? One. Come to think of it. We don't need that anymore. It was a beta tester. Oh, fascinating. Good to know. Good, good, good. Figured out half the puzzle. The other half is opening that door up. This is a water wheel. So we need to get that pagoda water out. In order to power this. But oh, I understand. That is the powerhouse for the water wheels. Okay. Okay, okay, okay. So we need to power the wheels in the Goda world over there. And that way we can get the green water that'll probably come through here somehow. No, it's that water, isn't it, that we need to get. But we need something else to get it. Might I say as well, beta tester. I'm sorry, because I know how frustrating it can be when you're watching somebody and they're just not quite getting the puzzle. And you sat there like, I want to tell them! So apologies in advance for that. That's a little too late for advance apologies, isn't it? Green. I'm good. Green. Green. I just don't want you to be like, oh, I should have known that. Okay. I'm quite happy to rattle my brain for a while on these things, I think. But it's good to know the offer's there. Oh no, I've done it again. Stop it. First, we need the water to open that. That water, no doubt, will come from there. Which I believe be Let's do this logically. This is the first puzzle we solved. Ah. Idiot. Now I understand what you were talking about. Okay. Redirect water, yes, that is excellent. So that was actually the one thing I didn't get was putting the thing on the tree, but thankfully, because it spawns this like right above the water, it actually shows you that, isn't it? Now what I need to do is redirect the water in a good way. So I want the water to go there. I'm not sure what I thought I was going to achieve.
Never mind.
I want it to come here to the pagoda. And then into there, directly. Okay. It was, again, more simple than I had anticipated. Oh. Yep. Hi. We did it! You watch someone getting super stuck here, I see. I can see how that's possible. I spent long enough, didn't I? But now we've opened this door, which leads us to the green area, and then we can repeat the idea. Perfect. This one. I need it to go off that edge, I think. And then apparently Twitch are looking to do squeeze back ads. Volume and video stays uninterrupted, but it squeezes down and is surrounded by an ad frame. Okay. If they must have ads, that's a better option than muting everything and putting it in a tiny window. Ads should be complimentary to the stream, not disruptive of it. Because by making them shit, nobody will want to use their services. Well, that didn't quite work as I'd expected it to. I wanna wrap around. This thing. Let's see what happens if I put this cube in different places. It like lands on that. This is the map place again, isn't it? Okay, it gets one bounce. I know I can do this with- oh, fucking- ah! There was another one the whole time! Ah, so funny! Let's do it. I actually saw that from the sky. Oh, I need to water it. I understand. I saw it from the sky a while back. And they gave me, like, 4 more cubes to work with. That's a lot of cubes. Water does not run upstream. Wow. Almost. There we go. No time for regular cubes, it's time for special cubes. That was a good one. Another tesseract, this time green, hopefully. Whoa! Chat, that was awesome. We did three of the big Bigu puzzles, and it's also these time to stream, and we're a little bit over, so I'll tell you what I'm gonna do. Let's go set a raid up. We'll grab the tesseract, stick it in its rightful place, and then we'll set a raid up. Yeah. Perfect. Just bash this, you know, object against the stairs and hope nothing ruptures in the fabric of space-time. Nice. Oh, that's a good tree. Okay, that one's balling out of control. Green. Three sides. Well, that seems like a really good place to save my game. Guys, thanks for watching Manifold Garden. I don't know, like I said, I don't know if I'll be here next Wednesday again, because I have to travel for Christmas, and I don't know if I'm traveling on the 23rd or the 24th, but if I am here, we'll play more of this. If I'm not, my next stream will be Saturday with Yakuza, and then I think we have some stuff going on Sunday, don't we? Advent calendar, Haunted PS1, and then an evening stream with my brothers! And y'all, because I think it's going to be fun, community times. So, without further ado, get this raid going.